Of ceremonies here this afternoon. I'm going to invite everyone to once again rise for our national anthem. And please face, and no, I will not be singing, and please face the flag. Started, I'd like to say a few thank yous and welcome a few people here. A few people did a lot of work, well, a lot of people did work towards preparing today's ceremony for our graduates. Some people who went above and beyond include Ms. Kara Frank, who prepared the programs, who did everything to get the graduates ready. A lot of work there. Also to Ms. Mary McCullough for her work in logistics, our custodial staff in setting up. Christopher Shedd did a lot to prepare the decorations and the student pieces of it. We also had some students help set up here today. Very appreciated. And I'd also like to welcome, we have some guests here. We have former teachers and staff from Osseo High School and from Maple Grove High School, as well as one of our alumni staff. I see in the back of the room, Mike Sheehan, who's here to celebrate with our graduates. So, certainly a number of people, and I know I missed 10 people that really contributed. But thank you to everybody for making this event come together. This is the second time that we have held the graduation ceremony in this format. Traditionally at Osseo Area Learning Center, students that graduated from our program would just walk with their home schools in the spring. And that certainly is also an option for our four graduates, or actually our six graduates, two are not here today. But for all six of them, that's certainly still a graduation. But we determined that we wanted to try and do something more personal and more timely, because for a lot of the students that graduate in January or February, it's a long time until June graduation. And so for that reason, we put this together for the first time for our trimester one graduates in December. We heard from students and staff that they felt it was a success, so we have continued it again this trimester, and with the intention that we'll be doing the same thing each trimester moving forward, at least some version of it. So thank you for being here. Thank you, parents. Thank you, families. Thank you, guests. And at this time, I would like to welcome to the podium our first student speaker today, Lauren Nelson.
Just work hard and get it done, and you can be up here too.
Woo!
Thank you.
And that brings us to our second student speaker today, Ms. Ania Dickerson.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sarah and Corey, for putting that together. Very nice. Next, I would like to welcome our next student speaker, Miss Olivia Taylor.
Thank you. There are many life situations that I have found that lead teens to come to this school. For me, the card that I was dealt with in my life was becoming a mother. And having my daughter, I never imagined myself having my child and being in a traditional high school setting. Continuing high school was never a question for me, it was always a given. A priority for my daughter, but most importantly for myself. And coming to this school, it was a set in stone way that I knew receiving my high school diploma would happen for me. These past 2 years here, I've received an immense amount of love and support from the staff and teachers here. It will be an experience that I'll always take with me. For a year now, I've had this power struggle within myself of being a mother, but yet still being a high school student. It has been something that I had to deal with in my mind for a while now. In the journey, however, I found that the staff and teachers here were very understanding and loving about my role as a mother. But in that understanding, I still kept the boundary of knowing myself that I am still a young adult and learning and growing. Even though I am a mother, I always respected the adults around me so that I can learn and grow in those skills of knowing my place in certain phases in my life. Now that I'm graduating today, the power struggle within me has faded. I can stand here today to tell all high schoolers that it is possible to graduate no matter what. I would like to give some advice here for the students here today. Come to school. I did it with a baby for 2 years, and you all can come here every day. Knowing and understanding your place as a teen and respecting the adults around you is key as well. Working hard in class and at home and making sure that no matter what, you do your best to put yourself and your education first because it matters. I would like to thank my supporting family who never gave up on me and supported my decision in becoming a mother. My best friend Ellie, who has shown me what a real friendship is, and Cheyenne, who welcomed me from here at the very beginning at school. The Shape Center staff, who took care of my daughter and loved watching her grow up as much as I did. And all the teachers and staff who have supported me and guided me as I continued high school as a mother. Conclude here today with reminding all that no matter what happens in your life, you can make something of yourself. I never saw myself in my life being a mother at this age, but I have shown myself, and hopefully others around me, that your dream or goal that you aspire to can be reached with hard work and dedication, and that you don't ever have to give up on yourself, even when life may seem to get a little tough.
The clear and primary purpose of today's ceremony is to recognize the hard work of our graduates and the accomplishments of our graduates. But we're going to take just a brief break from that, because the ceremony today also serves a second purpose. And that purpose is to show our current students that it can be done, that you can get there. And felt like this would be an important time or an appropriate time to recognize our highest achieving students during trimester two. These students were in the top 5% of academic performance. All of them earned all of their credits, and our assistant administrator, Mr. Powell, is going to come up and recognize our high honor students, we're going to call them, for trimester two.
I'm gonna call their name. If they're here, can you please stand up? You have to just hold your applause to the end. Mohanit, A. Is Mohanit here? Did I say it right? If I say your name wrong, don't be mad. Just stay standing in the right spot. Just stand up. Madison, C. Tamara, C. Tammy, Tracy, see? Tracy here? Tracy left. Morris, Lisa. Lisa here. Justin. Justin. Star. Haley. Haley here. Raise your. Right. Can we have a round of applause for these guys?
And now for our final student speaker of the afternoon, Aaron Isaacson.
How you guys doing today?
Good.
Say is Osseo Learning Center was a great experience for me. I want to thank all my inspirational teachers for being genuinely kind and believing that I too can complete my education. This will serve as a foundation for me to getting into college and moving on to the next stage of life. Also, I want to thank my family for pushing me every day to keep my head up and believing in me. With your guidance, everything was made possible in helping me move closer to my dreams. Everyone has a journey in life. The journey will always have a starting point, and from the starting point to the ending point, there will be obstacles that we must get beyond in order to get to our destination in life. Some of the obstacles will be easy, and some will be hard, but no matter what we do, we must face them. As a student who in the past attended South High and did not walk with this 2014 graduating class, I am standing here today to say, don't lose hope. Believe that anything is possible, and to continue your dreams, and they will come true, because life dishes out obstacles that can get in the way. Although it may not seem easy to see, every accomplishment you achieve is added to our world's accomplishments. Your individual success benefits our society as a whole, because when you succeed, you lighten the burden of the fellow man and woman. When you succeed, you're in a position to give rather than to take. Did you know that as of January 1st of 2014, there was an average of 3,030,000 dropouts a year in the U.S. That means there is about 8,300 dropouts a day, and 36% of those people are in the ninth grade. Now, from my understanding, those numbers are way too high. According to the U.S. Department of Education, 1 in 4 African-American students and nearly 1 in 6 Hispanic students still attend dropout factory high schools, where fewer than 60% of students graduate. I stand before you today breaking these statistics. Also, I wanted to congratulate the people who are graduating today. Can we give them a round of applause? We no longer have to believe that we are distant from reality anymore, because today is the day of a successful reality. Today, doors open for us that were not open before, and we break those statistics. It all starts today.
So I made a strategic decision that I was not going to give a speech today, and I made that decision because our 4 graduates that are here today were all speaking, and I thought, you know what, let's hear from them, you don't need to hear from the principal. And you can see why, because they all had great things to say, and they're all special young people. This is the 9th year that I've served as a principal in an alternative high school. And I've done many, many of these ceremonies, and I think with the 4 young people up here today, I've had more of an opportunity to get to know you 4 than probably in any other ceremony I've done before. And so I can vouch personally and tell you that all 4 of these young people are ready for the next stage in their life. They're all very special young people who are gonna go do great things. And you know, I'm very personally very proud of all 4 of you. And with that said, getting to the point where we can present the diplomas, which is a good thing. So, how this is gonna work is I'm gonna read the name of 1 graduate at a time. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about each graduate based on what they have written down and told and have been willing to share. And when I'm reading about you, you'll stand up, you'll walk over here, Mr. Powell will give you your diploma and a flower. and you can walk back around the back so we can get, make sure we get you in camera, back down the middle. Okay, so our first graduate today is Miss Ania Dickerson. Ania, would you please stand? Ania's favorite memory from the OALC is eating lunch with all her old and new friends, laughing, taking Snapchat pics, and having fun in a positive and relaxed environment. Her future plans are to become a nurse and further her education in the medical field. She wants to thank Westy for helping her with her math, and Mrs. Rasmussen also for helping her with math, Ms. Miller for being so nice, and all of the teachers and staff. Oh, and Angie for getting me into class without a pass. An important thing she learned at school, or a life lesson, is to stay focused. It was hard, but as long as you know what you want, you won't mind the hard work that comes with it. It's never too late to finish school and start your life. And her advice for the students remaining here at OALC is to work hard and stay motivated, to do the right thing, be patient and be humble. Ania Dickerson. Our second graduate today is Darren Isaacson. Please stand, Darren. Darren's favorite memory was every day he came to the OALC. Particularly Ms. Freeman's English class. He really enjoyed that class. His future goals and dreams include planning to get another job and following up with his college stuff. He wants to thank all the teachers because they were kind and thoughtful, and he says he loves the school. One thing he learned is that anything is possible when trying to achieve the next step in life. His only advice for students here is to continue and finish. Darren Isaacson. Our next graduate is Lauren Nelson. Under the pronunciation of her name, she has the best ever. Favorite memory from her time at OALC. There's way too many to narrow down, but maybe it was dressing up as Alm for Halloween. And you've already seen that picture on the slideshow, but in case you missed it or didn't quite get it, this is Lauren dressed up as Mr. Alm for Halloween. That was her favorite, one of her favorite memories. Okay. If anybody wants to take a closer look afterwards, feel free to come up. She wants to thank Holm and Bugan for putting up with me. Yeah, Bugan. Josiah for pushing me to go back. Erica, Courtney, Meet Maya, Logan, Ashley, Olivia, and Naya for making school bearable. An important thing she learned was don't wait to get it done. Do it as soon as possible. And her advice is to respect your teachers. They are here to help. Lauren Nelson. Our fourth graduate, Olivia Taylor. Olivia says that she just enjoyed being around the staff and the Shape Center staff. Future plans are that she's been accepted to North Hennepin Community College, where she's going to get her associate's degree in business and then continue to obtain her bachelor's degree in fashion merchandising. She wants to thank her supporting family, her best friend, and all the teachers and staff here who have supported her and cared for her and her daughter. An important thing she learned at school was that no matter what happens in your journey, life, it is possible to reach any goal that you set yourself to. There are many factors that can affect the journey, that as long as you never give up on yourself, anything is possible. Olivia's advice for students is that she advises students to not forget their role in school. You may want to act like you're an adult and better than getting an education, but in reality, these are your teachers whom you should respect. Work hard, stay focused. It's okay to socialize and have fun, but remember the main purpose of why you are in school, and that is obtaining your high school diploma. That should be a given and not an option. Olivia Taylor. At this time, I also would like to recognize our two graduates who are not here today, Jaden O'Brien and Andrew Hoppe, both trimester two graduates that could not be here today, but I thought we should recognize them also. So put a hand for our two graduates that are here. You can see it on TV or video. Graduates, will you please rise? And turn your tassels from the right to the left. I present you the winter 2015 graduating class of Osseo Area Learning Center.